You know what the tech industry needs? Another person making smartphones. Said nobody ever. But that is exactly what PC gaming powerhouse Razer has done, releasing its own Android phone. Now, you may be justifiably thinking, what can Razer do that other people haven't? Even HTC and BlackBerry, two former powerhouses, are struggling in the market at the moment. If you have a look underneath the Razer phone's metal chassis, you'll find a lot to like. And this is definitely one of the most interesting smartphones I've seen this year. Now, at first glance, it's business as usual. You've got a USB-C charging port, and sadly, like all phones at the moment, it's ditched the headphone jack. Under the hood, you'll find the same Qualcomm Snapdragon 835 CPU powering most Android flagships, and a similar dual-lens camera system on its back that pairs two 12-megapixel Samsung sensors. So far, so, right? But if you delve a little deeper, you'll find a few innovations that traditionally have only been seen on the gaming PC market. For starters, the 5.7-inch screen actually has a variable refresh rate. Now, refresh rate refers to how many times a screen actually renders images per second on a screen. The higher the number, the more responsive and smoother it looks. The flip side is, the higher the number, the more battery it drains. Variable refresh rate means that the screen can go between 20 to 120 hertz, depending on what it's doing, balancing power and efficiency. Now, this will be a big deal on things like games, where reaction time are a big focus, and the 120 hertz refresh rate will be a serious boon. Metal chassis has also been designed to act like a heatsink, which means it should dissipate heat a lot quicker, which means CPU and GPU performance won't ever be throttled. Again, a big deal for gamers. All of this sounds small, but it actually means the Razer is a pretty nifty device, and from what I've seen, it's pretty badass. The dual front-facing speakers are also insanely loud, and easily beat the HTC U11, which until now was the loudest phone I've ever tested. The only area I'm slightly concerned is software. Now, on paper, it looks okay, and the Razer phone is powered by Android Nougat overlaid with Nova Launcher. And an update to Oreo is confirmed, but it's the under-the-hood stuff that I'm concerned about. Camera optimization could be off, as Razer doesn't have a lot of experience here. And until I get to test battery life, I won't be able to tell how well the 4,000 mAh battery deals with the variable refresh rate, which, if it's not properly set up, could be a serious power draw. Still, even with these concerns, I can't help but get excited about the Razer phone, and really am looking forward to reviewing it more thoroughly.